Back when Juan Cabrillo first sailed into California in 1542, Terminal Island was much smaller, simply a sand pit at the end of the Los Angeles River. We don't know much about the island before that time, because few written records exist. However, it was called Rattlesnake Island in the late 18th century, around the time of the first California missions. Shortly after, San Pedro and the surrounding areas became booming centers of commerce. Phineas Banning's connection between Wilmington and downtown LA required a deeper bay for larger ships. When the US Army engineers built jetties in the bay for the deeper ships, Rattlesnake Island got more sediment from the river. And it grew. Then the LA Terminal Railway came. With increased access, people moved onto the island, populating little settlements like Brighton Beach. Rattlesnake Island was renamed Terminal Island, and more than 200 homes popped up. But big business was not going to be stopped. Canneries found the island to be ideal for processing fish. Before the First World War, over a dozen canneries were operating on Terminal Island, bringing hundreds of workers to sort and can the fish. It seems like every time they dredged the harbor to make way for new ships, Terminal Island grew with the dredged sand. A larger island meant more businesses. Although Fish Harbor and the canneries were a major economic force, other industries were starting to take notice. Shipbuilding, especially during the World Wars, employed many people on the island. Lumber and oil also provided jobs for many people. In response to the booming fishing industry, many Japanese families found their way to Terminal Island. Tiny homes were walking distance from the canneries, and over 3,000 Japanese Americans worked in commercial fishing fleets and the canneries. The military restricted access during the Second World War. Military camps and shipbuilding dominated the next few years as the U.S. government processed millions of tons of cargo and 500,000 troops from Terminal Island. Almost 100,000 people were now working in the shipbuilding industry, but at the same time, the Japanese internment during World War II vacated the neighborhood on the island, and it never returned. After the war, commerce resumed on the island, bringing a post-war boom. Shipbuilding, canneries, oil and lumber companies, customs brokers, and pleasure craft companies all shared space on the waterfront. By the 1960s, containers started to take over the shipping industry, and Terminal Island was one of the first docks to handle the giant containers on the West Coast. The shipping industry grew, and local fishing and canning shrank until 1972, when only three canneries still operated on Terminal Island. With the 1963 completion of the Vincent Thomas Bridge and growing international trade over the past several decades, Terminal Island continues to be an ever-popular and ever-changing fixture of Southern California commerce.